This week I'm going over what I learned from Shane Hurlbut's cinematography workshop. Hello, my name is Simon Cade and this is DSLRguide. So I'm sure many of you have heard of Shane Hurlbut because he's one of the few people in the mainstream Hollywood industry who are actually sharing their ideas about filmmaking. So a few months ago was Shane's cinematography workshop. It's called the Illumination Experience. And he basically has a whole bunch of demonstrations of different kinds of cinematography. And here's the key part, is that he actually explains his thought process and the meaning behind those cinematography choices. So when MZ gave me the opportunity to watch the video coverage of the event, I thought I could share with you guys what I thought of the kind of course on the whole. And obviously, MZ aren't paying me to make this video, and of course, I have complete control over what I say in this video. I'm free to give my honest opinion. Okay, so watching the first 20 minutes of the course, I have to say, it was pretty boring, actually. It was just talking about the equipment that he uses and all these different kinds of lights that are all way out of my price range. But luckily, the rest of the course, the other 6 hours, are letting the gear really take a back seat. So for example, in one of the many lighting setups that Shane demonstrates, they actually switched to using a DSLR. And I have to say, that has completely sealed in my mind the idea that DSLRs are good enough for filmmaking. Sure, the dynamic range may not be ideal and the image quality might not be quite as sharp as some of the other cameras, but if you pay as much attention to the lighting and the framing as Shane does, then that is just completely irrelevant, the kind of specs of the camera. So there's the first lesson I learned from the workshop, that I definitely don't need to be replacing my DSLR anytime particularly soon, because just the lighting and all the other parts of filmmaking are so much more important. And to be honest, every single shot they set up looked like it had come straight out of a movie, regardless of which camera it was shot on. And it's so good to be able to see how they then made that shot, and even more importantly, hearing Shane's thought process as he is setting up these shots. Now, of course, making cinematic images is not the main purpose of a cinematographer. And I have to say that the biggest lessons I learned from Shane have been about how we can present emotions and ideas through the lighting and through the camera placement. I think my favourite was him breaking down a lot of the shots and scenes from a film he worked on called Crazy Beautiful, and seeing how, for instance, he lit Kirsten Dunst to be very kind of harsh and in a very unflattering way, but because that really fit with the kind of mess that her character was in. And how the first time we see her character in one of the scenes, we can just see her head above the table, and how that kind of relates to as if the table is the ocean and she's just struggling to stay above the water. And I think that totally works for the kind of character and the kind of way that that character was feeling. And that, to me, is what was really valuable about this course, was to be able to hear him talk about how the characters were feeling and how the story was going, and then to talk about the cinematography choices and how they all related to each other. But it was also good to see how Shane sets up a shot after understanding the reasons why. So for instance, just seeing his passion and his absolute attention to detail was really infectious, and it got me more excited about lighting than I have been in a long time. And the way they did this was they had this big rig with a lot of lights on it, and it was rigged up on a circular dolly track. So that way they could just spin the lights to all the different angles, and then the really useful thing was to hear Shane's kind of commentary on that, talking in real detail about the shape of the shadows and how these different angles of light will affect the shot. It definitely got me thinking about lighting on a much deeper level. Now, I have to say that as I was watching all of these lighting demonstrations, I couldn't help but give some of the credit to the really expensive equipment and the really expensive lights that they were using. But then Shane grabs some Home Depot lights and a shower curtain and recreates one of the shots that they previously did with really expensive lights. And I was amazed at how closely he managed to get it, where he was paying a lot of attention to the direction of the light, but also using gels to match the color of the lights. And then the main thing was using flags and diffusion and different ways to block the lights. And I have to say, you know, a lot of people say that they can make Hollywood lighting on a shoestring budget, but I have to say that I haven't seen anyone do it better than Shane. Now, of course, as a Hollywood DP, he knows the technical side of filmmaking like it's the back of his hand. And seeing how he works with stops of light, for example, so where he would say, right, we're going to change the aperture of the lens down to a stop and a third, which then means we'll need this ND filter to be swapped out for this one, and just making those quick calculations in your head so that you can keep the exposure exactly the same. And also, you know, he would be moving around a reflector and would know exactly where to angle it so that the light would be exactly in the right place without needing to look back at the monitor. I think it's these things that just having that kind of long experience allows you to not just be trying stuff and then looking at the monitor and seeing how that looks, but to actually anticipate exactly what each of these decisions are going to do. And I think that is definitely the mark of someone who's got a lot of experience. So that was a big takeaway for me, to be able to see how well he knew what he was doing. So another benefit of learning from someone who's got many years of industry experience is listening to the way that he talks to his crew. So for example, if I tried to explain to someone exactly how to set up a light, how high to put it, where to put it, and in what direction to point it, then what you'd probably find is that it's actually quite difficult to explain all of that information, you know, turning it counterclockwise, clockwise, moving it camera left, camera right, and how much you want them to move it. It's quite hard to give all that information just using words. So I always find it really interesting, whether it's Vincent Lafouret or Shane Hurlbut, to be able to hear exactly how they're talking to people on set with those really precise instructions that do definitely make things a lot more efficient on set. And finally, I want to share two of the best principles that I've taken away from watching this workshop. And the first one is that cinematography isn't the most important part of a film. In many cases, the actors and their performance will actually be more important than, say, the lighting. Now, you often hear about cinematographers who are kind of holding up the whole shoot because they want to get their lighting perfect. And the way Shane put it is that sometimes a cinematographer has to just let go, even if the lighting isn't perfect, because if you stop the whole shoot just to tweak a little light, then that could kind of lose all of the momentum that the actors have built up and that the director has been working to get. So the second one is that Shane believes that a cinematographer should often be a bit more like a producer than a director. So normally you have the producer who's really thinking about the budget and the time constraints, trying to get everything finished without going over budget, while the director is kind of pushing in the opposite way, just trying to get their vision told and not worrying too much about the money. So Shane's idea is that if the cinematographer can make the shoot really easy for the director by giving them plenty of time, not spending too much time on the setups, which also means not spending as much money, and being really efficient, that's the key. So the director will have more time to focus on getting their vision without being distracted by the producer always saying, we need to stay on budget. So those are some of the things that I've learned from the Illumination experience. Obviously, I couldn't fit everything in since I'm making such a short video. But I have to say that overall, the workshop does just go further than pretty much anything you can find here on YouTube in terms of learning about filmmaking. I think that's just because of the simple fact that Shane is, as far as I know, the only kind of full-time, legit cinematographer from Hollywood who is actually sharing this much about what they know about filmmaking. So that's pretty much it for this week. As always, there'll be all the relevant links on the blog post, including the trailer for the course if you're interested in watching the Illumination experience. But that's it for this week, and I'll see you next time.